Dad is Catholic and a lot bigger, okay? So, so in my family, my dad is like, he's built like Steve. And I'm built like my mother. He just doesn't want to go out with me. Play cards. Okay. I want to say, I've always enjoyed, I actually have some written down too, like on paper. Because I met a lot of people that are like, you know, you're going to be up there. And I saw the wedding ringer 2 weeks ago. Okay. Like, give me that Kevin Hart guy. The guy who talks about Hitler. Okay, so, I don't want to be that guy. And I just did. Okay, so. We're in a conversation. So, the beginning part of this I'll remember, okay? So, it's always funny how you meet people, okay? So, a lot of people you know, like your whole life, like Devon and Thong Chai knew each other from birth. Titles, yeah, so. Devon was his half French, so. Sanchez is a little bro. Sanchez is Mexican, by the way. So that'd be. That's one thing, boys. Is playing late. Good band. No, I mean honestly, it's always funny how you meet me. And when I met Steve, he had no interest in getting to know me. He actually told me, like, let me press it real quick. I go to Palm Springs, okay? Hey, surprise. So, really? Like, honestly, so when I grew up, everything I did kind of looked like me. So, I just meant Jewish. So I came to college my first year. I had no friends, and honestly when people say they have no friends, I had no friends. I had one friend, she was my first girlfriend, and I hated her. It was a good time, okay? I had no friends, and then I joined a fraternity, okay? I joined it, and then Bengal, he's up there.
He's over there.
So I rushed, and I met Steve, and he had no interest in getting to know me. And he literally told me that very early in our relationship. He said, you're a spring bus. And if you're a fraternity guy, what that means is, we try to get all the good people early. And then you came. And so we just took you, okay? which was cool. Wait, I mean, nothing wrong. I'm in. Okay. Like, he left the name. Okay, and I was like,
I agree.
Shit, I'm in. Okay. So, I didn't think that would last for like a short time. And that was a year, okay? And my first time that we really got to know each other, we were actually playing cards. Oaktown's finest, Trevor Penn, we're going out. And he's like, honestly, you're gonna meet a celebrity. He's like, we went out, we were hanging out, and Steve takes me there in his car, and I had this on my list, but Steve was the original raver, okay? Like, you know, like some people are like beep, 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 beep. No, I mean, he was like, he was into trance. He was into house. He knows beat tracks, okay? And so you get in this car, and I had this conversation when we started dating Lindsay. I was like, honestly, you're like, you should really play maybe some bands. Like, a dashboard, a band, something with instruments. And I was like, honestly, play some instruments. He didn't do it. He loves house music. So, That's how we did it. And so, point is, I got it.
Yeah.
So, anyway, Steve was the typical fraternity guy. He stayed up late, he got bad grades, he worked at a hotel, he'd come home at 2:30, he'd eat a taco, he'd call it a day, and no one can know anybody. And never paid his dues. Mr. Thompson. When I met Steve, he had no interest in getting ugly because he was too cool. You have to remember, this was a different time. What was cool then, young kid today may not think it's cool. Steve drove a 96 Accord. This Accord was loaded. That had a disc changer. Ready 125, a disc changer was R equivalent to an iPod shuffle. The big claim on this Accord was that Steve lined it with dynamite. One Mexican guy from Chino, Colton, okay. Honestly, Dynamat was this thing that you put in your car. And so if you had like a bass that hit, we had this conversation earlier, it would stop your car from vibrating, okay? It did not stop his car from vibrating. It was literally the type of car that you could not help but look at, okay? Yes, people did look, okay? Mainly because Steve would blast trance, house, hip-hop, all the music that nobody listened to at the time. Now, everybody listens to it. You were the first guy.
You're a pioneer.
It did nothing for you, okay? And I have to say that of all my friends, Steve was the original Raven. And I'll tell you right now, that is a big pile of fist bump, okay? I'll tell you the truth though, Steve is really one of the best guys I know. Honestly, honestly. Yeah, honestly, as good as he is, he's the nicest guy in the entire world.
Yep.
In my next life, I'm going to go through a Steve, and I'm going to be a really nice person. I'm going to push people out of the way.
Yeah, Bubba!
Thank you. I'm really nervous for it. We are...
You had a driver.
Yeah, really. We're stuck together. My mom loves this guy. And I have a very Jewish mother, which I had a conversation with her. My dad's Catholic, my mom's Jewish. I'm the only war. It's really awkward, okay? Don't worry about it. So, like, my sister, my old sister's like 40 something. Steve's a year older than me. A lot older than I am, so my mom and sister are like 15. My mom used to talk to Steve like, hey, I was letting you know that like this doesn't work out. You can marry my daughter. She's like, no. She's like, well, she's really
yeah,
old.
Hello.
The end.
He didn't. And you know what, the best about Steve, he stays in contact with everyone. Honestly, I don't know yet. So, he's always telling me how he just got the phone with some like name you've never heard of in years. And, just last week, he was talking about Jason Duckworth or Chris Dubas. I'm not sure who he was talking about. So I was talking about how I met like my mother, Josh, thank you. I haven't seen you in years. You may remember that. That's bothering me. So my My method of attack is wit and sarcasm. Because I weigh 150 pounds. So, Steve, like he's a gentle giant, but he picks up people and he throws it out. So, I got it. Thank you. My last statement is, honestly,
come on, man.
In my entire life, I've known him a long time. We lived together for 8 to 10 years. And in my entire life, I've never met anybody who lets Steve be who he is. And I mean that seriously, because honestly, everybody knows him. They love him. We all humiliate ourselves, but she truly lets him be who he is. He loves her.